Hi everyone, today I'd like to do a sequence for balance. There are different ways to approach the issue of balance, but today I want to focus on stabilizing the hips and strengthening the thighs, the quads. And if, like me, you've got a weaker side and you tend to press more on one leg than the other, it's really good to do this sequence as well to prevent lower back issues. To do the sequence, we need a chair. And we also need a block. But if you don't have a yoga block, you can simply take a towel, fold it in three, and roll it very tightly. And that's perfectly fine as an alternative to a block. So we'll start by standing beside the chair with the feet hip width apart. And lift your toes, spread them apart, bring them back. And try to really press on the four corners of your feet. And we're going to challenge ourselves a little bit by leaning forward and backwards. Make sure that you hold the chair for stability. But when doing that, we're playing with the idea that you have to first lose balance before you get it back. So it's quite challenging for your body, but it's a good thing to do as well. Then leaning a little bit to the right and to the left, just a few times. Okay, and coming back to center. Next, we're going to take the block or the towel, and we're going to place it between the thighs. And the idea is to squeeze the block. And when you do that, you can feel how you engage your quadricep muscles. Lift your kneecaps, press on the four corners of your feet, gently engage your core as well, roll your shoulders back, and you are standing in Tadasana, the mountain pose, really strong standing pose. We're going to inhale, circle the arms overhead, hands touching, look at your thumb. Exhale, draw your hands in front of the heart center. We'll repeat that. If it's too much for you, for your stability, you can keep holding the chair and not do the movement with the arms. And last time, inhaling, circling the arms up, hands touching, exhaling, hands in front of the heart. If you want to challenge yourself a little bit more, you can close your eyes as well. Gently open your eyes, release the hands, and we're going to now move into Utkatasana, the chair pose, and we do it using the chair as well. So turn your chair so you are standing in front of it. Keep your block between your thighs. Inhale, bring the arms up, either parallel to the floor or if you want a bit higher. And then slowly sit back until you are sitting on the chair. And make sure now that your ankles are directly under your knees. Adjust your block if you need to. And squeeze the block. Squeeze and feel how you are strengthening your legs. Press again on the four corners of your feet. It's actually quite a strong pose. And if you feel that you have the strength to go further today, bring your arms again parallel to the floor or a little bit higher. Lean forward, press on your feet and come up with or without the chair. And slowly sit back and come up. Good. that 3 to 5 times or even more, depending how you feel today. Last one, stand up completely. You can now release the block. And you don't need a chair anymore, so replace it away. And we're going now to lie down on the back. Bring the feet hip width apart, close but 3 inches away from the gluteus, and take the block again and squeeze it between your thighs. Keep your arms along the body, and then press again the four corner of your feet on the mat. Inhale and lift your hips while you squeeze the block. And slowly release on the exhale. Inhale, lift, press on the feet, squeeze the block, go as high as possible. Exhale down. Inhale, lift. Exhale, down. And do that twice more. And last time. The block. And next we're going to turn and lean on the side. And you can use your hand as a support for your head, or you can lie down on your arm, whichever is more comfortable for you. And we're going to bend the legs, but bring the feet together. And then, so make sure that you are in line, so with the shoulders, the hip, and the feet. I like to keep my hand on the hip, and as you inhale, lift the top knee. Exhale down. And we'll do that a few times. And it's important not to move the hip. So it's only the knee that goes up and down, and it's actually harder than it looks. You can really feel the muscles engaging in your hips. Last one. Next we're going to extend the top leg. It's parallel to the floor, flex your foot and lift the leg. You don't have to lift it too high. Make sure that you stay in line and that your hips don't go back or forward. Next we're going to turn around and lean on the other side. So bending the legs, bringing the ankles together, making sure that there's nice alignment between the shoulders, the hips and the ankles. Inhaling, lifting the top knee without moving the hip. And down. Okay. Next, extending the leg parallel to the floor, flexing the foot and lifting. So the important thing is not to go as high as you can, but to keep the alignment and really engaging the muscles in the leg and in the hip. And last one. And again, you can now come back to sitting. So that's the sequence for balance for today. I hope it helps you. Don't hesitate to contact me on tamingthewalrus@gmail.com if you have any questions. Thank you.